Welcome to the webcast demonstrating integration of architecture models and behavior models among different tools and languages. We will demonstrate this with MetaEdit Plus. When focusing on modules and architectures, we usually focus on different level of details. For a specific feature, we look one feature, usually one engineer edits at one point of time a small model. In architecture work, we focus on large systems with various views. So we have a number of different engineers and they use collaborative editing, working with the same models at the same time, keeping them inconsistent. So our focus is then large systems of interest. Let's look sample architectures a little bit more detail. What I have here is sample models on different areas. Requirements models, design function models, and here you can see one component model showing various functions and their interfaces, perhaps the most typical approach. So here you can see functions, different kind of ports, their connections, ports are of different kind, and this is the logical view, but we may have also other views, like for example the hardware architecture view, where we have power supplies, sensors, actuators, ECUs, like for example here, the green ones. So here you can see different kind of network connections, I/O connections, power supply connections, and so forth. The architecture modeling language allows us also to see different kind of allocations made between the views. Here is a matrix view where we can see different kind of functional components and hardware components and then allocate them together. And these allocations, then we can use various needs to generate different kind of software configuration, for instance. There can be also different ways to visualize them. So when we go back to the hardware architecture, we may want to show the allocations made in the hardware architecture. And now you can see here in the model that this ECU central has three functions, but the brake actuator only allocates one function. There can be also other integration with requirements management tools, and we can also perform various kind of model analysis at the level of architecture models. For example, safety analysis with error behavior. Architecture models can be translated to Simulink and weak version. So what I have here is a small example of an architecture model. And I can conclude this design by connecting brake torque to this other port in local device manager. And if we don't have yet Simulink models existing, we can then produce them by generating those files. And now we see the result opened in Simulink. And if you would like to check the consistency, we can run consistency checking report in MetaEdit and find out that obviously, just generated Simulink model is consistent with the original architecture model that is in MetaEdit Plus. But then different people can edit these at different point of time, for instance, add things or here remove things from Simulink. And if we save the model in Simulink, then we can run checking report in MetaEdit Plus to see whether this is inconsistent, the architecture model is consistent with Simulink. And now we can see that something is missing from the Simulink model. Something that we originally planned for architecture model is not there. We can go back to the Simulink and bring it back the component, save the change, and go back to the MetaEdit to run the checking again. And now, again, the models are consistent. Rather than running the consistent checking all the time, we can also ask MetaEdit to run it while we are modeling. So here in the live check pane, we don't show consistent checking, but we show one checking report in particle for Simulink consistency. So now if someone changes and stores the model, saves the model in Simulink, MetaEdit Plus shows immediately in the architecture models that a component is not anymore in Simulink. So at the bottom you can see those checks been executed at the modeling time. So now Simulink model is updated and the check is consistent, shows the consistent. We can also do changes not in Simulink but actually back in the architecture model. So if we add here a port, inflow port to the architecture model, like a position one, then immediately in the live check pane at the bottom we can see that this position port is not found from the Simulink. And if we click things in a checking report, the underlining words like the position, we can trace back to the original design model to find out where it is added. And also if we remove things again here from MetaEdit side, it again checks that how things are in Simulink. So checking is implemented with generator system of MetaEdit, and as generators are fully open, you can modify and extend the checks as you want. For integration tools, we need to provide mechanisms, and MetaEdit provides various kinds of interfacing mechanisms. In this demo, we just use a generator for creating the models or calling other tools. We can use API and other mechanisms of MetaEdit Plus. So with MetaEdit Plus, you can integrate models, tools, and languages using different kind of technologies. Thank you for watching the video demonstrating integration of MetaEdit Plus with Simulink tool.